one word that describes my relationship with Ruby on Rails.
Special.
Love.
Fun.
Magic.
It's complicated.
Yeah, I think complex. Yeah, complicated works.
Very Facebook-esque answers, you know? Your relationship status, yeah, it's complicated.
Ruby on Rails, in one word, would be empowered. You can do so much with something that, in the grand scheme of the world, is kind of small.
One of the key problems that Shopify is trying to solve with Ruby on Rails is to get it to scale to a massive size.
A lot of the problems we are trying to solve are like how to make Rails easier for new developers, how to make Rails easy to work with larger teams.
We're solving problems anywhere from security to speed optimizations, enhancements. We're really thinking about the future of Rails and how we can help it continue to grow with the needs of its user base.
It keeps changing and it keeps getting better. Like, Rails 7 is one of the most exciting releases of Rails ever. Like, who can say that after having their framework be around for, I don't know, since 2004 or whenever Rails was created?
Why do you continue to invest in the Ruby or Rails community?
I like this question. I really like this question.
We continue investing in Ruby and Rails to make sure the language and the framework are 100-year languages and frameworks, and they are top choices for new people coming into the community, and they continue working for Shopify as well.
It's not just an investment in the technical side of, let's only do stuff that benefits us, let's only do features that Shopify needs. It's features that everybody needs to scale and grow and use Rails and Ruby for the foreseeable future.
Programming in Ruby makes me happy. Using Rails makes me happy. And I want developers around the world to feel the same joy that I do when I'm developing Rails applications.
I feel like I really belong to this community, and I feel like people deserve to feel that way.
There's so many really nice and talented people who share their knowledge, and so many people that I look up to.
Love it.
Nailed it. The end?
The end. I think that's a wrap.
It's a wrap.
Hey, everyone. This is a really big room. Welcome to day two. I am Mike. I work at Shopify. I've been asked to say a few words. They're my employer, though, so it's going to be a little one-sided. That said, I am happy to have a candid conversation about what it's like to work at Shopify. So if you want to find me and have a good conversation about what I like and what's painful, happy to do that. So let me start with a simple fact, which is that Shopify and Rails have really grown up together. Both were just, you know, little baby things in 2004 when our CEO, Toby, was one of the original Rails contributors as well as a Rails core member. And Shopify's product was built on top of Rails, and the Rails doctrine is part of our engineering culture. So if you think about like developer happiness, omakase menus, sharp knives, majestic monoliths, it's all here. Shopify's product vision is pretty simple. We want to give entrepreneurs everything they need to run their business online and focus on what makes them great. Sorry about that. I'm trying to balance two laptops up here. So in addition to the storefront experience and payment gateways, thank you, Evan. You're so kind. So in addition to payment gateways, we're also doing things like merchant financing. We have warehouses for drop shipping. We're trying to get all of our merchants to be able to do 1 or 2 day shipping to compete with Amazon. So if you think about it, like we're trying to help merchants build their own brand and just focus on what makes them great. We actually are featuring two Portland local merchants here this week if you want to stop by the Shopify booth. One is Loop, which are earplugs for quieting down the noise of the world. And the other one is Smith Tea, who actually have a tasting room here in Portland. So if you're interested at all in, I think that we have some samples and stuff down there too, just stop by the booth and check it out. But I want to come back to Rails, right? So we're able to actually scale all the way up from those small merchants to huge merchants like Sephora, Budweiser, Red Bull. And we do it all with Rails. And Shopify's success is due to Rails, and so we want to try to pay that back as well as we can. And so I want to just spend a minute talking about how we pay off that debt, but also contribute back to a much larger goal. So it's really common inside Shopify to talk about wanting to be a 100-year company. And just like think about that for a second, like 2122, if Shopify is still around, what will be different about the world? That feels like a super ambitious dream. But part of my job is to think about what is the tech stack gonna look like for Shopify in 2122? Is it still gonna be Rails? Like, mind blown. If it is, I want my team to have contributed to making it true. So how do we make Ruby and Rails 100-year tools? I think the it's not just making Rails great for new projects, it's things like, I have a list. Production performance, making sure that you can actually scale out when you need to. It's well-formed opinions on application architecture. It's easy upgrades, it's great editors, it's avoiding anti-patterns in your code base. It's about choosing when you want to use the power of types in your code base. So Ruby and Rails, So the idea is we want to like define what Rails at scale means, and it means not just thousands of engineers, millions of lines of code, billions of web requests, but also hundreds of years. This is the goal. This is what we're trying to shoot for at Shopify and on my team, which does a lot of the open source work that you've heard about. So just a quick rundown. We're trying to improve tooling. We open source a lot of the tools that we use. We're trying to make VS Code the best of breed Ruby editor. We added Rails support to Sorbet. We're working on making upgrades, automating upgrades to Rails easy. We're trying to focus on Ruby performance. So we created Widget. We're working with Oracle on Truffle Ruby. We're doing variable width allocation. We're working on object shapes. And we also just announced $500,000 in funding for computer science researchers. Finally, we're trying to work on the security of the ecosystem. So we've been contributing upstream to Bundler and to rubygems.org. And in a couple of weeks, we're going to announce a long-term partnership with Ruby Central that I'm pretty excited about related to the open source supply chain. So keep your eyes open for that one. So the video you just watched was all folks who are on my team at Shopify. Some of those faces are probably familiar because they are world-renowned experts. Some of those faces are not familiar to you. Someday they will be, because we're growing the next generation of Ruby and Rails experts as well, who can continue the work and hopefully give us a chance at having a 100-year tooling and ecosystem. Anyway, that's it. That's all I wanted to talk about for Shopify. Hopefully I've explained a little bit behind our motivation. We're not so big and scary. We're just a group of people who are trying to do our best to make Ruby and Rails last as long as possible. Again, if you want to talk about working at Shopify, that's great. But my real hope is that you get to use some of our software and that someday we get to collaborate with you on making Ruby and Rails 100-year tools. Thanks.